hey man, real stay safe shit. You already know what the fuck is going on, man.
Man,
we gotta talk about some shit that is very near and dear to my heart. This shit is fucking hilarious as fuck. This shit is a fucking Tory Lanez Cassidy situation that is occurring right now. So basically what happened was this nigga fucking Cassidy, I mean, like, he's a fucking goat of the 2000s era, and niggas cannot say shit about that. Like, that nigga basically sort of like set the ground for like all the rap shit that we have today, and including Tory Lanez's career, because he credited him as his favorite rapper. But basically, fucking, it's been a minute, like, actually, that this shit has been in the making. But ever since like 2017, this nigga Tory Lanez has been out here fucking making, like, I don't even know, like, freestyles. I think it's just freestyles. I don't think it's like actual songs where he quotes him word for word, but he basically quotes this nigga word for word like a motherfucking instructional pamphlet or some shit.
Smoke like quick drags, I click fast and bang your bitch ass. Brain from your chick in the whip that I just crashed.
Seriously, I click fast and bang your bitch ass. Ain't nothing changed, I got cane for the quick cash.
That's why I feel like I'm the most hot in the place. A lot of niggas saying they hot, but they not in the place. And your block, it ain't hot, man, it's safe. Next nigga diss Tory Lanez, about to get shot in his face.
I got more change than you got in my couch. And the next cat scream my name, gonna get shot in the mouth.
A few moments later.
And my leprechaun bundles is getting them dummy high. I sold fives and 25s from 25.
My to sell 20s, that'll get you dummy high. Bagged in the 125, 125s.
Nigga X about me, nigga X about me, nigga X about me, nigga X about me. I'm a hustler, I'm a hustler, homie. I'm a hustler, I'm a hustler, homie. Nigga X.
Like, this man straight, like there's several Funk Flex freestyles where he just quotes this nigga. Like, I wouldn't even say quote this nigga. This nigga straight plagiarized this nigga. This nigga basically copied this nigga's whole fucking bars word for word. And I feel like he thought that, like, the people that fuck with Tory Lanez's music were, like, people that were, like, from the younger generation. Probably, like, the oldest AB is, like, in their mid-20s and not really even know, really, who Cassidy is or his music. So this nigga thought that he could copy his shit bar for bar, like, no cap, like, verbatim, like, what this nigga be saying, bro, like, verbatim. Like, this shit is kind of crazy. But what would you expect from a nigga with a fucking Patches O'Houlihan ass hairline? So basically, this nigga basically copied this man word for word on, like, all sorts of freestyles, ranging from, like, 2017 to even fucking, like, 2020, like, fucking damn 3 or 4 years, word for word, just basically stealing bars and shit. And that shit crazy, bro. This nigga was doing this all with his fucking nappy ass hairline, all that shit. Now, number one, I never even really saw the appeal that people, like, had for Tory Lanez, because this nigga is a fucking weirdo, bro. Like, off rip, the nigga, like, 5'2". Nothing against short people, but the nigga 5'2", bro. And not even in a cool way like DaBaby. I mean, DaBaby's already on some weird shit right now, but, like, this nigga short as fuck on some weird shit. Not on no Uzi shit, on some weird shit. Big ass head, looking like a fucking thumb, bro. So basically, this nigga copied his whole shit word for word. And then Cassidy called him out originally. And then he was like, nah, bro, you were my favorite rapper and shit. But I really feel like he said that on some shit, like, he was trying to, like, kinda, he didn't expect for him to fucking, like, see the freestyles, and he thought that, like, he could get away with that shit, and that not enough people even knew who he was, or he wasn't really relevant to the point that, like, he would even get in trouble for it. So, like, I honestly feel like it was some crazy shit, and just over time, I guess this nigga Cassidy was like, yo, this nigga stealing my flow bar for bar. So this man dropped a whole ass diss tape on Tory Lanez called Perjury. I mean, what else would it be? This shit is straight up perjury. This man, off rip, y'all don't even gotta fucking listen to the song, bro. Look at the cover for the song. This nigga has the fucking fucked up ass hair, bro. They got this nigga. This man looks like a fucking baby that just came out of the womb. His hairline is so fucked up, bro. This nigga looks like an infant. This nigga looks like a baby when their fucking shit just starts growing in. But like, that's his hair plug, bro. Like, that shit is fucked up. And like, this nigga really flamed it. Like, off rip, off the cover art alone, like, this nigga already, like, this nigga dropped a whole diss track, but you don't even gotta listen to the diss track, bro. Listen to the fucking, look at the fucking cover art off rip. That shit is funny as fuck. That shit is hilarious. That shit off rip is one of the funniest things I've seen this entire year. Even though it looks like some, like, 2000s, like, early fucking 2000s old head shit. That shit is funny. I'm not gonna lie. And he basically dropped a diss track on, like, how Tory Lanez has been stealing his bars word for word. And he was basically saying, like, look, like, he, like, Tory Lanez was acting like he was supposed to be honored that this nigga was stealing his bars word for word. When the average person that isn't really on some rap shit, that doesn't really even know that it's, like, some young kid that's suggesting this music, doesn't even fucking know, like, about, like, they might know who Cassidy is, but they don't know, like, his music to the point that they would be able to quote his shit. And I guess Tory Lanez is taking advantage of the fact that he thought that people wouldn't know. So I feel like that shit hilarious. Will it end his career? Probably not. But will it make him, I mean, it makes him look funny. Honestly, I don't even know how. How in the fuck are niggas still fucking with Tory Lanez, bro? Like, this nigga is not even fire. Like, this nigga does not, like, he drops some fucking lyrical miracle shit, and niggas act like this shit is the fucking birth of Christ, bro. Like, this nigga fucking sucks. This nigga is not even, like, who the fuck, niggas in Canada be listening to this shit? I don't even know, bro. This shit is just goofy at this point. And niggas be trying to, like, fucking, I can't even believe that people are out here fucking trying to say that this nigga did not, like, whether or not he shot Megan, it doesn't even fucking matter at this point. Cause it's like, if he's included in the incident and she has bullet wounds and he had the gun, basically shows that this nigga, even if it wasn't intentional, accidentally shot her. Like, why the fuck does this nigga even have bands, bro? This nigga is a 5'2 fucking gremlin. Nigga with a fucked up ass hairline looking like a Gerber baby, bro. Niggas need to reevaluate their whole life. Everyone who fucks with this nigga, but I really don't even think that people fuck with him. Cause it's like, could you imagine buying tickets for a Tory Lanez show? Answer that question in the comments. You already know. Real Stay Shit.